Assalamu alaikum students, welcome to Air Foundation School System. This is class 8 and this is your physics lecture. In previous lecture we discussed about length measuring instrument vernier calipers, and we defined the vernier caliper that it is an instrument which is used to measure the small lengths such as the volume of a sphere, the diameter of a sphere, etc. So the vernier caliper is an instrument which is used to measure the small lengths. Now today we discuss about the another length measuring instrument, that is screw gauge. And screw gauge is more precise than, more accurate than vernier calipers, and its least count is the smaller than vernier calipers. So we define the screw gauge as it is an instrument which is used to measure small lengths with greater accuracy than vernier calipers. As I told you that it is more accurate than vernier calipers, it measures the length with greater accuracy than vernier calipers, and it is also known as micrometer screw gauge. Now we move towards the construction of screw gauge. Screw gauge consists of a U-shaped metal frame, and a stud. This is the stud of the screw gauge. Here it is shown, and here this is the stud of the screw gauge. Next, it is consists of a hollow cylinder with millimeter scale. Here it is shown. This is the hollow cylinder with millimeter scale. It is also known as sleeve. And here I shown you. Here, this is the hollow cylinder. This is the hollow cylinder with millimeter scale, and this line is the index line on the screw gauge. This is the line which is known as the index line of the screw gauge, and this scale is known as the hollow cylinder or sleeve, and this scale is known as the main scale of the screw gauge, and the index line is graded on the main scale. This is the main scale of the screw gauge, and here a rotating scale. This is the rotating scale. This rotating scale is known as the circular scale of the screw gauge. Here it is shown. So it consists of a U-shaped metal frame, a stud, a hollow cylinder with millimeter scale, a thimble with threaded spindle inside it. This is the thimble. This is the thimble with a spindle inside it. Rotating spindle. This is the rotating spindle inside the thimble. So its construction is a U-shaped metal frame, a stud, hollow cylinder with millimeter scale. It is known as main scale, a circular scale. So this is all about the construction of screw gauge. As thimble completes one rotation, spindle moves 1 millimeter along the index line. This thimble completes one rotation, then this spindle moves 1 millimeter along the index line forward or backward. So this is the rotation about the thimble. When thimble completes one rotation, spindle moves 1 millimeter along the index line. Next we move towards the pitch of the screw gauge. Actually, the pitch of the screw gauge is the distance between the consecutive threads on the spindle is 1 millimeter. The consecutive threads on the spindle is 1 millimeter. So here is the consecutive threads, consecutive gratings on the spindle. So consecutive threads on the spindle, the distance between the consecutive threads on the spindle is 1 millimeter, and this is called the pitch of the screw gauge. So we can say that the pitch of the screw gauge is 1 millimeter. Next we move towards the least count of the screw gauge. So the least count of the screw gauge can be found by the pitch of the screw gauge divided by the number of divisions on the circular scale. Number of divisions on this circular scale, here it is 50. The number of divisions on this circular scale is 50. Usually it is 100. And so the number of divisions on circular scale is 100 or 50. So least count of screw gauge is, the pitch of screw gauge is 1, and the number of divisions on the circular scale is 100. So 1 divided by 100, that is 0.01 millimeter or 0.001 centimeter. So the pitch of the screw gauge is 1 millimeter, and the least count of the screw gauge is 0.01 millimeter or 0.001 1 cm. Now next is the working of the screw gauge. In order to calculate the length with the help of screw gauge, first we step is to find the zero error in the screw gauge. To find the zero error in the screw gauge, we close the gap between the stud and spindle. We close the screw gauge in such a way that the spindle and stud touches each other in this way. When spindle and stud touches each other, then we can see the zero of the circular scale and the index line of the zero of the circular scale and the index line of the main scale. If the zero of the circular scale and the index line of the main scale coincides each other, then there will be no zero error in the screw gauge. If the zero of the circular scale and the index line of the main scale does not coincide each other, then there will be the zero error in the instrument. It may be positive or negative. Now let's see when it is positive and when it is negative. Now the positive zero error comes when the zero of the circular scale is behind the index line. The zero of the circular scale is below the index line, then zero error will be positive in the screw gauge. To find the screw gauge zero error of the screw gauge, the number of deviations behind the index line, multiply these number of deviations by the least count of the screw gauge, we get the positive zero error in the screw gauge. Similarly, the negative zero error comes when the zero of the circular scale has crossed the index line. The zero of the circular scale is above the index line. Then there will be the negative zero error in the instrument. To find the negative zero error, the number of deviations that are above the index line, multiply these number of deviations with the least count of the screw gauge, we get the negative zero error in the instrument. So this is all about the screw gauge. If you have any problem regarding the lecture, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you so much. Take care.